In February 2014, the Fabula Nova Crystallis came to a close with Final Fantasy XIII Lightning Returns. XIII-2 was a wide-open reality and time-hopping adventure with Noel and Lightning's sister Sarah that ended in a calamitous release of Chaos Energy, stopping the clock for the inhabitants of Nova Crystallia for 500 years by the time the third game in the series picks up. It also somehow stole 2 hours from each day, but that's a minor issue. Wait, you know what? No. So, clocks in the first two games went up to 13, most notably in the intro to 13 too. Now, for some reason, the days are only 24 hours long. Hope kinda talks about this at one point, but even he doesn't really know why it happened. Personally, I think the only reason might be the time mechanics in this game. While the prior game felt like a new Chrono game, this one harkens back to the Valkyrie Profile series, with the rush to save souls against the ticking clock of an impending apocalypse. I think they might have felt a 26-hour day would throw off Earthbound players. No, not that Earthbound. And put a feeble explanation for the shift to 12 hours, much to the dismay of any Bajoran fans of the series. Lightning's goal is to finish quests to put the souls of Cresselians at ease, saving those souls in the Ark for the trip to a new world set aside by the god Bunavelsa. The act of saving these souls also generates an energy called Iradia that can be used to regenerate Yggdrasil and give the world a few extra days before Ragnarok. You start with only 6 days remaining, but you can get up to 13 days if you play your cards right, giving you more time to save more souls. Battle is a variation on the Paradigm system, but since it's only Lightning this time, it's tailored to her going solo. Speaking of tailoring, you collect outfits that represent a different set of skills and stats, equipping 3 to have available in battle on a moment's notice. I loved the Paradigm system, and this is a decent evolution, while still maintaining the core of the original Final Fantasy XIII method. The entire party, save Sarah, is back in widely varied roles, each of which having coped with the 500 years of frozen time in their own ways, and this half-millennial freeze presents the biggest problem with this world when you sit down to think about it. No one's aged. Death can only come from sickness or physical damage. Sounds great, yeah? Until you start talking to the people. Like this lass here, who appears to be in her early teens. She had a crush on her drama teacher, but despite being under his tutelage for 100 years, he could only see her as a young girl and her love went unrequited. How about these old people? Living for hundreds of years with deteriorated bodies, or even worse, a child born just after the Chaos Flood that has remained an infant for 500 years, with his mother doomed to care for him over the same amount of time. It's not just the people, either. One of the quests you can take on is to basically cause the extinction of every monster species that remains in the world. There are a fixed number of each enemy you encounter. After you've defeated all of them, an Omega version appears that's got a boost in its stats over the general lot. Kill off the Omega, and that enemy will never show up again. It gives me kind of the same feeling I had when I first completed Virus Inc. Hooray, I won! I won. All in all, it was a solid ending to the trilogy, and I rather enjoyed replaying it for the video footage. It was the first PS3 game I really dove back into after getting my PS4, and I was pleased to see social media integrated for sharing screenshots and such, though those functions are offline now. I'd recommend it, but only if you've played the rest of the series first. Thanks for sticking around for this look at Lightning's Return. Got any comments on the world of Nova Crystallia? Leave them below or on Twitter at TesseractUnfold. In the meantime, please like, subscribe, spread the word, and I'll see you all again next week.
Your sister. I don't even know you. How do I know you're not lying to me?
Well, you're just going to have to try. Ooh, I know! I can tell you all about me and my past until I convince you I'm a friend. It all started back when...
Wait, never mind. I trust you. You're on my side. Please, stop talking.